Back to Harbaugh, suspected Fort Hood shooter. In fact, indicted Fort Hood shooter, Major Nidal Hassani. He was indicted today on 13 charges of premeditated murder. He could face the death penalty in a military tribunal. President Obama ordered a review of all intelligence gathered on Hassan and whether it was properly shared and acted on, which seems to me a very open question right now. So why was this fair there to connect the dots? We've got the dots. Nobody connected them. National Public Radio's Daniel Zwirling reported that top officials and psychiatrists at Walter Reed held a series of meetings over the past year and a half about this man, Hassan's personal behavior, and wondered whether he could pose a danger if deployed into Iraq or Afghanistan. And Bobby Ghosh is senior editor of intelligence and terrorism reporting for Time magazine. Bobby, thank you. I want to get to you in 1 minute. Congratulations, Daniel, because you gave us new information here. Tell me what you were able to report about the way in which people could observe this figure in the United States military before what happened.
Picture this. A year and a half ago, a bunch of the supervisors of Nidal Hassan's in the military at Walter Reed and at the military university where he was on a fellowship actually started having meetings in meeting rooms in the hallway, and they started wondering, could Nidal Hassan actually be psychotic? One of his supervisors...
What does psychotic mean?
Good question. Psychotic is sort of a broad term that people throw around, but it basically means detached from reality. And
it means no sympathy for anybody you might kill, among other things.
Well, I think that's a little too harsh, but it means people who are loners, who are sort of have disoriented thinking, people who
like taxi driver.
But I'm not a psychiatrist. But
you saw the movie, Taxi Driver, yeah, Paul Schrader's movie, Bobby De Niro, right? That's the kind of guy, loner, dangerous.
A guy who is mentally unbalanced and who gives us pause. One of his supervisors actually started musing to colleagues, I wonder if Hassan is the kind of guy who might leak secrets to Islamic radicals. And another supervisor, according to my sources, started musing aloud to colleagues, I wonder if he's the kind of guy who might commit fratricide. In other words, remember the American sergeant who was in Kuwait, who set off grenades in tents, killed 2 people and injured 14.
Okay, here's the bottom line. You got all these dots. Nobody drew the lines connecting the dots and said, don't send this guy to Afghanistan. He may go haywire. At least that. At least don't send him overseas.
What they did do instead is they said, where could, in the spring of this year, we're just talking about a few months ago, they said, where could we send Nidal Hassan where he will do the least potential damage? And the answer was Fort Hood, Texas. Why? Because Fort Hood, Texas has more mental health specialists, more psychiatrists than probably most other Army bases. So the thinking was, if we send him there, there's going to be enough psychiatrists that who will carry the weight if he doesn't do his work, because his work record, which we can get into, was really poor. Number two, they thought these psychiatrists could support him, perhaps help him get better.
It's horrible.
Monitor.
Okay, here's the question. Last thing I want to get to Bobby. Why didn't they say his fitness is not there? He's not fit to serve as a United States officer. We're not sending him anywhere. Why didn't all this add up to this guy's dangerous? He may be psychotic. We're not going to deploy him anywhere. We're going to take him under surveillance or put him into some sort of hospital and see what happens.
There were actually a whole bunch of factors that are sort of unrelated. A few psychiatrists said to me, you know, so we were actually worried, what's it going to look like if we weed out one of the few Muslim psychiatrists we have? You know, what happens when the Equal Employment Opportunity Office breathes down our necks and, God forbid, the ACLU? But some people had very well-meaning intentions, which was they were teachers and they wanted to help Nidal Hassan try to focus his energies and try to improve. They took their jobs as teachers.
You know, this sounds like every defense of those priests in the Catholic Church over the years that had problems. That sounds like that. Transfer them around, try to educate them when you have a real problem. Let's go to Bobby Ghosh right now. Bobby, this thing has gotten very serious. Your thoughts on what you have to report here.
Well, I'm interested to know why those doctors at Walter Reed and the university didn't put their concerns on Hassan's personnel records. Because when the FBI tracked Hassan writing those emails to the radical cleric in Yemen, somebody at the Joint Terrorism Task Force looked at his personnel records. If these concerns were in those records, somebody would have set off some red flags and something would have happened. But it sounds to me like they didn't make it to the records. These were concerns that the doctors had, but they kept them to themselves. And that's one of the many places along this sort of long unfortunate chain, where connections were not made.
Well, it seems like these psychiatrists, in answering your questions, Dan, were using as their foil, we didn't want to be discriminatory, when in fact the evidence they had pulled together this guy had nothing to do with profiling him or his background. It was his personality that they were observing. It wasn't where he comes from or what his religion is or where his parents came from. So it seems to me, Bobby, that all the evidence they had on him was personal. It wasn't ethnic. It wasn't in any way prejudicial. No, and yet they were afraid to operate on it. That's scary that they're so hamstrung that way.
That's true, but it would still, if this happened, I would expect it to turn up in people's personnel records. Here's another consideration, though. If they were trying to help them, why didn't they take him by his hand? Why didn't they pull him in and say, listen, you're not all right. We think you need some help. We think you need medication. You need counseling. There doesn't seem to be any record that they did that. Instead, they were sending him to Fort Hood thinking somebody else would take care of the problem. It sounds to me like they were passing the buck a little bit.
Let's go back to Dan.
Well, Bobby makes some really good points. Some people did try to help him. The teachers at USIS, that's the medical university, really
tried. That's out here in Bethesda.
Yes, right next to Bethesda Naval Medical Center. They really tried to work carefully with him, and they counseled him. I don't mean therapy counseling, but they tried to help him understand, here's how you should think logically. You know,